콜먼트 플럼빙.
예, 감사합니다. 네, 오늘 우선 모티베이션부터 시작해 보겠습니다. Let me introduce some basic definition of rational blowdown surgery. Rational blowdown surgery is a general relation of the blowdown surgery in complex geometry. Let me briefly leave the blowdown and let S be a smooth complex surface and let P is any point in S, then we can take a tubular neighborhood, a neighborhood, say UP or U, which is biholomorphic to T4 or P. And in this open neighborhood U, we can take two coordinates, say X and Y. Then the set you had is defined by some points in this subset, in this set. U times P1, which satisfies this equation, this one equation. And as you know, there is a natural projection map from U head to U. And the blowing up is the surgery pasting U head and the complement of S of P along U minus P, which is biholomorphic to U head minus the inverse image of P. That is, in U head, there is minus one curve. That is a curve C, which is isomorphic to P1, and its self-intersection number is minus one. And if this is given by the inverse image of P, and epsilon is a biholomorphic map from U hat minus epsilon inverse P to U minus P. Therefore, we can glue these two complex surfaces along these two open sets. And blowdown surgery is the inverse of this blowing up surgery. In 1997, Lonestan, they invented a new surgery, so-called rational burden surgery. And Professor Jong Il-bak at Seoul Regional University generalized their rational burden surgery. From now on, I briefly review the definition of rational burden surgery. I don't know the name of the.
Yes.
Because Jong Il-bak was a student of Pintusen. Maybe Pintusen suggested Jong Il-bak to improve their results. Definition. CPQ is a tubular neighborhood of some linear chain of spheres. That is P1. And each sphere has a negative self-intersection number. That is, for example, minus P1. The self-intersection number of the second sphere is minus P2 and minus Pk. Here, we have three conditions. First one, P, they are relatively prime, and P must be greater than Q, and each self-intersection number Bi must be greater than or equal to 2, and PQ and BI satisfies its negative continued fraction equations. That is, P square over PQ minus 1 is equal to P1 minus 1 over P2 minus 1 over BI minus 1 minus BI. CPQ is a small neighborhood of these linear chains of spheres. And this tubular neighborhood is also called plumbing. For example, if we have minus 4 curve, only one curve, then its tubular neighborhood is equal to C to 1. You can check these three conditions. And for example,
if you have some integers that are used continuously.
Yes.
Are they uniquely decided?
Yes. They are uniquely decided by this PI. And for example, minus 5 and minus 2, this plumbing is equal to C31. And in general, if we have this diagram, here is a rational curve with the self-intersection number minus P minus 2. And the other rational curves have self-intersection number minus 2. And the number of minus 2 curves is P minus 2. Then the small neighborhood of this linear chain is equal to CP1. Pintisel and Stern created rational blow-down surgery for CP1 case, and 종일박 generalized their surgery to CPQ case. The definition of rational blow-down surgery is as follows. We know that the boundary of this CPQ is the range space. Range space at P square PQ minus 1. And the second one, this is the essential condition, essential result, essential fact. There is, say, PPQ, a rational ball that is, it has a trivial rational homology, and its boundary is equal to this range space. In general, CPQ has some rational homology, but this PPQ has no rational homology, but they have the same boundary. Therefore, we can glue. If we take this kind of length space, then yes.
So not in general?
Yes.
The length space is not yeah.
In general, rational length space maybe does not bound some rational ball. Yeah. That is, in our case, our surface G, in general, this is a and any four manifold with some CPQ. There is some linear chain. And the complement is, say, G0. Then we can cut this CPQ here. The boundary is range space at P square and PQ minus 1. We cut out this CPQ and replace it by this rational ball PPQ. Since they have same boundary, we can replace them. And this surgery is called rational blow-down surgery. In fact, Chimington proved that this rational blow-down surgery is, in fact, a symplectic surgery. That is, if we have a symplectic four-manifold, and in there, if we have some CPQ, then the rational blow-down four-manifold also has a simplex structure. The question is that can we perform this lesional blow down surgery in the category of complex geometry. That is, we ask that the rational blow down four manifold has a complex structure or not.
This is generally not a birational
yes.
thing, but it is a possible effect to me.
Yes. The answer was given by Professor Jong Il Bang and Professor Yong Nam Ni at Seogang University in 2007. They use a so-called Kugelstein smoothing theory in order to prove the existence of complex structure on this rational blow-down four manifold. Let me briefly review their methods. Here we have a complex surface say G, some part of G0 and with some CPQ and since the intersection matrix of this linear chain is negative definite, we can contract them. Then we had a surface, a singular surface, with a singular point, say, x0, and with one singular point. And, G0. Yeah. And this singular point is very special. It is called a singular point of class T. Here, a singular point of class T is a singular point that has a local Kugelstein smoothing. That is, we can smooth this singular point locally. Here, Kugelstein smoothing is a smoothing whose relative canonical divisor, say, is Q 같아요. Is Q 같아요. Then their idea was that we deform this singular point, this singular surface. The main question problem was that there is a global Kugelstein smoothing or not. If there is a global Kugelstein smoothing, then we have a flat family, let me draw like this, over some small disk with a central fiber is this singular surface X, and its general fiber, say XT, is smooth. And the existence of global Kubrin-Stein smoothing is guaranteed by the vanishing of this homology. That is, if H to Tx, this homology vanishes, then there is a global Kubrin-Stein smoothing of this singular complex surface, then we can get a smooth surface, Xt. And this Xt has some relation with the rational blowdown four manifold. That is, if we blow down, rational blowdown if we rationally blow down this complex surface, then we have some symplectic four manifold G0 with a rational ball VPQ. Then it is a basic fact from Miller fiber theory. That Miller fiber theory says that the rational blowdown symplectic four manifold G bar is diffeomorphic to the general fiber XT. Yes. Yes. This implies that we can give a complex structure on this symplectic four manifold. Therefore, Zhong-Yulbach and Wiley, their results can be summarized that Kubrin-Stein smoothing is a complex version of rational blowdown surgery. But we have one condition. Kubrin-Stein smoothing is a complex version of rational blowdown surgery if this cohomology vanishes.
Usually when you do a surgery, there's a big part of the manifold that you don't want to change. Mm-hmm. But here, it seems that you must change everything.
Yeah.
So, but is it really the case that you know that you must change? Or
we must change this part.
This has been changed, right?
Yes.
But do we know if maybe we can hope that actually we didn't change? So that would be really a very
In some case, we did not change this part, but we want to change this part. Let me show some applications. Yeah. By applying their results, they and also including me can construct many examples. By applying Kubrin-Stein smoothing, they can solve many geography problems of complex surfaces. General type. Let me first define the geography problem. As you know, if S is a complex surface, surface of general type, then their invariance, say K square and holomorphic Euler characteristic chi H satisfies four inequalities. For example, they must be greater than zero. Therefore, the invariance of K square, the invariance K square and chi H must lie on this set. And there is a famous inequality, so-called K square must be less than 9 chi H. Holomorphic Miyaoka Yao inequality. And they must satisfy some inequality. Say, so-called Redder inequality. And it was a very old problem to find a surface, complex surface of general type with geometric genus is equal to zero and its irregularity also equal to zero. They rise on this vertical line. It was a very old problem to find the complex surface of general type lying on this vertical line. The first example was constructed by Paolo in 1984. He constructed a complex surface of general type with DG invariance PG Q equal 0 and K square is equal to 1 and especially simply connected. That is, Paolo constructed a surface corresponding to this point. And the next example was constructed by Jung Il Bak and Yong Nam Lee. They constructed a complex surface of general type with these two invariants and K square 2 and simply connected. They constructed the second example lying on this point. And by applying their results, their Q-Greenstein smoothing method, Hee-Sang Bak and Jung Il Bak and me, constructed two more examples. Surfaces of general type with two vanishing invariants and K square 3 and 4 and simply connected. We constructed two more examples here. And We can construct the examples on the next vertical line. The only known example was a complex surface with k-scale 1 and 2 on this vertical line. But we constructed a complex surface of general type with pg equal 1 and q equal 0 and k-scale 1, 2, 6, and 8. And simply connected. And 종일방 and 용남리 and we also construct many examples with some small torsion. In general, it is very difficult to construct some complex surface with vanishing invariants and with small torsion by classical methods, that is quotient or covering method. But Q-Greenstein smoothing method is very good to construct some complex surfaces with vanishing invariants with small torsion.
Small torsion
where? H1. The first homology group. But all these examples constructed by applying Q-Greenstein smoothing method has this vanishing condition. That is, if X is a complex surface, a singular surface of class T, but its second cohomology does not vanish, then we don't know anything. That is, we don't know whether X has a global Q-Greenstein smoothing or not. In fact, by applying Q-Greenstein smoothing method, we cannot find the next example. It is k-scale 5 example. This example cannot be constructed by Q-Greenstein smoothing method. Let me briefly introduce some basics on moduli space. Let M A B is a moduli space complex surfaces of general type. K square is equal to A, and holomorphic Euler characteristic is B. It has been known by Zipf that such a moduli space exists. Then, by Yuji deformation theory, if S is a point in this moduli space, then the dimension of this moduli space at this point S is greater than or equal to this number and less than or equal to H1 STS. It is an easy fact. Therefore, if we want to find a surface with this vanishing condition, then the left-hand side of this inequality is equal to 10 minus 2k square . This follows by Riemannoff theory and the vanishing of global H0 for surface of general time. Therefore, if S is a surface of general time with k square pi, then the left-hand side vanishes. And this modulus space is smooth at this point. There is only one point at S, on S. This implies that we cannot apply Kubrenstein smoothing method. For finding k square 5 example. Because at this point, if this surface cannot deform, therefore, if we want to find a surface with k square pi, then we have to accept the condition that we have to deal with example with this condition. Fortunately, there are two examples. For example, that is, there are many examples having Kubrenstein smoothing although this second cohomology does not vanish. For example, Professor Yongnam Lee constructed 9 examples. His examples constructed from E4. This is an elliptic surface with minus 4 sections. If we choose a general E4, then there are 9 minus 4 sections. And let WK be the singular surface. Obtained by contracting k minus 4 sections. Since minus 4 curve, the tubular neighborhood of minus 4 curve is C21, this singularity, singular point, has a local Kubrenstein smoothing. But note that H2 of TE4 does not vanish. Hence, our singular surface WK also has a non-vanishing H2. However, Yongnam Lee showed that there is a global 2 grams times smoothing. If we contract more than 2 curves. And it is easy to show that there is no global Q-Greenstein smoothing if k is equal to 1. In this case, if there is a global Q-Greenstein smoothing, then the general fiber violates the Nader inequality. There is also another example by us, H Park and me. I said that we constructed a complex surface of general type with P is equal 1, Q equal 0, and K square is equal to 8. In order to construct such an example, we first construct some surface which is 4 CPQs, but in this case, by contracting this CPQ, we have a singular curve, singular surface with 4 singularities. But in this case, we checked that this cohomology does not vanish. However, we can show that there is a Q-Greenstein global Q-Greenstein smoothing. This example shows that there is some weaker condition than the vanishing of Tx. We know that if this is equal to 0, then there is a Q-Greenstein smoothing. But there are many examples with non-vanishing H2, but there is a Q-Greenstein smoothing. Therefore, my main question is that, is there any weaker condition on the existence of Q-Greenstein smoothing? Because the condition, this condition, the vanishing of H to Tx, this condition comes from the X with isolated singularities. That is, for any complex surface with isolated singularities with H to Tx is equal to 0, then any infinitesimal deformation of X can be glued together and they give a global deformation. But our examples have only singularities of class T. This singular point is very special. Therefore, I want to find some weaker condition on the existence of global Q-grid transmitting. In order to solve this problem, I want to find a complex version of reasonable lowdown surgery. Without the condition for this question, suppose that we have a surface with singular point of class T, say here, then it is well understood that,
excuse me, class T? Class T means the divisor is just a line?
No. Singularity of class T means that there is a local Q-grid transmitting. Yeah. It is well understood. The deformation smoothings of a neighborhood of singular point. This theory was developed by Golla and Shepard Baren. Therefore, we need to understand the deformation of the complement of singular point. Well, since this singularity can be obtained by contracting some linear chains, this question is equal to understand deformations say why this is given by some g is a minimal resolution of x and we want to delete some open neighborhood singular point. Therefore, this corresponds to plumbing of each resolution graph. Understanding of deformations of this open complex surface would be the first step to study this question. And recently I have some results on this direction. Let G, here G, G is a surface and there is an ample any amplifier. And suppose that there is a CPQ in G. Then the first order deformation of this set Y is given by this cohomology. It is a well-known fact. And I can prove that there is a...
So what is the fact?
This cohomology have all first order deformations of Y. Yeah. And the first result of mine is there is a tubular neighborhood say U of this linear chain. In CPQ such that the second cohomology vanishes, the second cohomology of tangent shape vanishes. Here, y is given by g minus u. Since y is not compact, this condition does not imply any integrability condition on first order deformations. But anyway, we can find such a tubular neighborhood. And I can construct some infinitesimal deformations contained in this set. Here we had an amplifier. Then it is a very easy linear algebra that there is an effective divisor. Say here CPQ constituted by C1, C2, say this M rational curves. Then there is a effective divisor say x1 c1 to xm cm such that h1 tg and e this cohomology injectively goes to dy. Therefore they give for any n. Therefore, each space H1, TG, and E gives us infinitesimal deformations of Y. Here, XI determined, they are determined by uniquely determined by the amplifier H up to constant 1 to 4. And I can show that this does not vanish. That is, the dimension of this infinitesimal deformation space is grows quadratically in N. And if we add one more E, there is an inclusion. Therefore, 2, 3, 4, these three results shows that there is a stratification. And finally, the implicational deformation given by this space it gives a say non-trivial deformations. That is, if we have here is our surface G, and there is some linear chain, C1 to Cm, and we remove some tubular neighborhood of U, and the complement is our surface Y. Then the element in this set, in this space, deforms the complex structure of some curve away from the boundary. Therefore, the infinitesimal deformations given by this space deform the whole space. I have to find some very good infinitesimal deformations such that the infinitesimal deformations of Y, say Y bar, which can be integrated to give us deformations of Y bar, we have to find such an infinitesimal deformation, and the boundary of Y bar must be coincide with the boundary of PPQ. If we can find such an infinitesimal deformation, then we can apply rational Brodermann surgery in complex structure. This is my further research. 네, 여기까지 하겠습니다.